And welcome back. Joining us now to answer your pet questions is Dr. Kim Hammond, getting a big kiss there from Duncan, right?
A big wet Akita kiss. This is a really cool dog. I wish you could feel the coat on this dog. This is a Mannerschwarz fur coat.
Yeah, good for winter.
Oh, my gosh, good for winter. You know, it's interesting, too, actually, now that you say that. You know, dogs don't have sweat glands. So even in the summer, these guys don't get hot.
Yeah, well, that's why they're always panting, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Sweat through the tongue. Yeah. All right, you ready for a couple of questions?
Absolutely.
All right, we're talking puppies here. I just got a new puppy for the holidays, and I went online. There's just so much, too much information. What's the first thing I should do?
You know, Lowell, this is interesting. The internet is our friend and our foe. There's way too much information on the internet. You can't dissect through it. So let me give you a little friendly advice about pet medicine. Use it sort of to set yourself up for the phone call to your veterinarian.
Right.
But your veterinarian really is going to dissect through it. You know, when you think about it, there are only a few symptoms out there. There's vomiting, diarrhea, maybe lifting a leg, a cold. Mm-hmm. But there are a plethora of diseases associated with all those symptoms.
Right.
First thing to do with your new puppy is get to a veterinarian, bring a stool specimen, make sure they check it out, and they'll tell you everything from there on in. But bring a stool specimen, get to your veterinarian.
All right, sounds good.
All right, come here,
next question. I will be
here,
he's having a good time. He misses his mom and dad.
He does.
I will be away for New Year's, and I'm leaving my cat at home, who is terrified of fireworks. My house is next to the fireworks site. What can I do?
Okay, I'll tell you what you have to do. You have to find a place to take your cat.
Yeah.
And you take your cat to a place that has 24-hour care, and someone can be looking at your cat, because anywhere in the metro area, in fact, all over the state of Maryland, there's fireworks, even local people. And you need someone there who really understands how to calm your cat and love your cat.
Right.
So, go online, search out kennels, 24 hours, and find a place. I would say if your cat is terrified, really, that can maybe also medicate it if it gets really crazy.
Yeah, they probably need some company with the fireworks.
So scared, yeah.
All right, we have a 2-year-old rescue dog. About 6 months ago, he started nibbling on blankets, sheets, clothes, and pillows. Does he have some kind of vitamin deficiency?
Absolutely not. No vitamin deficiency. It's a normal behavior to do that. I mean, you're lucky he's not eating up your dining room furniture. But there are ways to stop that, and I like to go to You Silly Dog. She's a dog trainer. She can teach you how to get your dog not to chew on things at home. And you don't say no to chewing on the blankets. You say yes to chewing on something else.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Different
All right, Dr.
behavior.
Kim Hammond, some good advice, and Duncan, right?
Yeah. Happy New Year.
All right. Happy New Year to you too.
Yeah.